Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from Haydock Park here on Saturday. It is April the 27th, 2019. I'm going to look at the featured second race, the 205 from Haydock, but before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5 for more selections for race courses around the world. The second race, the 205 from Haydock, is the Betway Old Boston Handicap. It's a Class 2 handicap going for a purse of $57,500, race for 4-year-olds and upwards, field of 14 horses going 1,400 meters or 7 furlongs on the turf course. Top selection, I'm going to take the number 2 horse, Burnt Sugar. I'm going to go 2.11.8 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. 2.11.8 Tri-Cash Trifecta. Top selection is 2 horse, Burnt Sugar. You don't want to burn sugar. Well, you do want to burn sugar a little bit to make caramel, but if you burn it, it actually does taste burnt. I'm probably the first person in the world to ever make burnt ice cream. You say, burnt ice cream? How can you burn ice cream? I made salted caramel ice cream last year, twice. First time came out great. Wanted to make it again in August when it was 100 degrees out, and I burnt the caramel. And you can't try caramel when it's piping hot, so I made the ice cream like I normally did. When the ice cream was finished, turning, took it out, tasted it. It was burnt, and I invented burnt ice cream, which I'm quite proud of, which, of course, we never ate because it's burnt, but, you like they say on, like that old joke on SpongeBob, you burnt my shake. Well, if I made a shake out of it, probably was burnt, but let's get back to the 2 horse Burnt Sugar. Seven-year-old gelding by Loop the Bag. I'm going on tangents here. Ben Curtis gets leg up for this one. The horse is most recent out again, 7th of October, Longchamp on good yielding ground. 7 furlongs in the Group 1 Prix de la Forêt. He finished 13th by 6 lengths, and he was against tougher horses there. He was outclassed by the others. It wasn't his day to win. Before that, at Leopardstown, the 15th of September, 7 furlongs on a premier handicap. He finished 6th by 1 3/4 lengths, and again, he just never got into it. Again, tougher horses. And then his last race, where he was against his own kind of horses on the 25th of August at Goodwood, 7 furlongs on a Class 2. He finished 11th by 6.5 lengths there, and he was in a lot of traffic trouble, and again, he just never got into it, but it was against his own company he lost that day. And then his last two very good races came on quite firm ground, which we're going to see today. And Ascot, 7 furlongs in a Class 2 handicap, July 28th. He won by 3/4 in length, and he won very nicely. And then before that, Newmark on the July course, 7 furlongs in a Class 2, he won by 1/2, and again, he won very nicely. He's going to see firm ground today. He has a good post draw. He has high weight, but I think he can overcome it. This race is, I think, this race is not nearly as tough as the other few, and I think he'll run well. So 12-1, I'll take him. So let's get that Burnt Sugar here. So to recap my selection for the second, the 205 from Haydock. I'm going to go with the 2-horse Burnt Sugar. I'm going to go 2.11.8 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. So good luck to him. Please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5. Good luck, everybody.